Hey folks, Don Spencer, president of the Oklahoma Second Amendment Association. A really good question came up and I was asked to see if I could provide an answer for. So here goes. In Minneapolis, where law enforcement have now done a questionable act, which is actually terrible. And the question is, if a law enforcement officer is involved in a murder or a felony, can you stop or interject or intervene in that act and it be legal? Well, I'm going to try to give you an idea of what you can and cannot do. First of all, let's go ahead and base this off of Oklahoma law, which would be the stand your ground law, whether you have the right to defend yourself or defend another person. But here you got to keep in mind, folks, if you're going to defend another person, that other person cannot be involved in a crime. So let's clarify, this gentleman that is now deceased was in the act of forging or trying to pass a fake $20 bill. He gets called on. Now, when the law enforcement show up and arrest him, that crime should be considered over at that point. And law enforcement made the effort to tell us that this man was resisting arrest, but we also can see in video that he's pretty much docile. But there is a gap between him being moved into the vehicle, and then the next video you see of another person watching as he's got a knee on his neck as this officer keeps it there for 8 or 9 minutes, which is just incredible. So let's just go this from Oklahoma law. You do have the right to intervene in another person who is being has a life-threatening situation against them. There's no question about the law says that. But I'm going to tell you straight up, in this event, if you were to try to take on a police officer, and especially with three other officers present, and you think you're going to incapacitate them to save that person that they're harming, you are most likely going to be killed yourself, or you're most likely or spend the rest of a lot of time in jail or prison. Because keep in mind, if you think you're John Wayne, and you're going to incapacitate four trained police officers, when the word gets out that there's officers down, how do you think the rest of these officers are going to respond? Do you think they're going to show up and give you a high five? You think that they're going to believe anything you say? So again, I'm just going to tell you the best thing in this scenario is exactly what happened, and that would be to just be a witness. Pull your phone out, record, let them know, ask them to get up, ask them to quit doing what they're doing, and try to record that be used as evidence in court against them. Begin. Yeah, you have the right to defend that person on the ground, but again, you will never win because you'll be charged with murder. You'll be charged with working against a police investigation or situation, and the district attorney is going to be right there, and he's going to make sure that you don't get away with this also, and your life will be completely turned upside down for a person you don't know who they are, for sure, but you're also watching an incredible act take place. So my advice, again, pull your phone out, record it, ask officers to stop what they're doing if you were to ever find yourself in that situation. Now, I'm going to talk directly to law enforcement. Officers, this is the problem. One person can obviously put stains upon the whole industry of law enforcement. Where is it that we want officers to respectfully think for themselves? We don't know why the man was placed on the ground. Maybe we'll find that out. But there's three other officers there, and you can't tell me you guys couldn't manhandle a guy to put him in there. This is where us common folk just want to know what you guys are doing, if whether this be a part of training, whether it be a part of policy, or whatever it is, we want you to think for yourself. And the reason we want you to think for yourself is because if you're willing to do that to a person, that means you're willing to do that to come and take our guns away from us. And that's exactly because, hey, this is how we were trained. Hey, this is what we were told to do. Hey, this is how we respond. This is how we react. And that's where that's where the sentiment against law enforcement, one of the sentiments, is negative. And so with OK Two-Way, we want to make sure we work that law enforcement with law enforcement and inform law enforcement that, you know, what the laws are to keep both the citizen and law enforcement both on their sides of the law that they're supposed to be on during that kind of a situation. So, again, folks, you're not going to win in any capacity, in any way, if you think you're going to intervene on a complete stranger like that situation. Now, if someone says, well, Don, what if I know the guy? Let's just stick with the exact situation we got. We know these people didn't know the guy. They just knew what was going on was wrong, and we actually watched. And the term has been used, lynching, and I'm going to agree with that term, because this is just what has taken place is so heinous. It would have been more justified for the officer to pull his gun out and shoot the guy in the head than to put him through the agony he did for what he did. And which, by the way, the guy's still dead either way. One's just as wrong as the other. And again, there's an issue here. Also, I don't want to make this a black or white issue. This is not a color issue. That is just wrong. You don't have to be a cop. You don't have to be just any citizen to know that. So again, I'm bringing us to the point. Yes, you have the right to defend another person, but the fact is, in that type of a situation, you simply may not win physically, you may not win legally, and the challenge is everything is against you. So my advice is pull out your cell phone, record the situation, be prepared for evidence, and unfortunately, that is some of the things we have to deal with in a free society. But we always, always will seek justice. We have to seek justice, especially on situations like this, because one, the Minneapolis Police Department has a terrible reputation of dealing with the public, and they've just compounded. Now, let's go one other thing real quick. This does not justify people going in and stealing toasters out of Target. There is no way that this is justified. But I will tell you, there's a lot of people out there that are good, straight-thinking mind people will think, huh, they're burning down the police station. Well, they shouldn't do that, but we sure hope the police get the message on this, which is a terrible thing to think too. But there's a lot of people out there that think like that because, hey, if you guys are going to be that belligerent, you kind of got it coming. And the fact is, no such thing is justified. But you can understand why people are thinking and doing that way. And that's not good either. So law enforcement, you've got a long hill ahead of you because of events just like this. These guys were brazen. They didn't care. Didn't listen to any request. And their lives would have been endangered had they intervened. So this is where we need law enforcement to actually think with their own head and do the right thing. And again, OK2A, we are far from being anything anti-law enforcement, anti-cop, cop-hating. That's not us. But again, we're going to point out where there's a problem, and we're going to point out where we think we can help fix it. And like I say, this is what we're going to do at OK2A. This is Don Spencer, President of the Oklahoma Second Amendment Association, on self-defense for another person who is under an attack by a law enforcement officer. If you guys like this, follow me on YouTube, follow us on Facebook, OK2A.org. Have a good day.